Muslim brothers and sisters, I wanted to talk to you about not following your exhausted emotions. Do not follow your emotions blindly. Your emotions could prevent you from ascertaining your dreams. I have survived the storm. I survived two wars. I survived covert operations. Some of you've survived the storm of your marriage. You survived the storm of bad family relationships. But when you finally accomplish the things that you wanted to accomplish, you give up and one foot of water. Why? Because you have what is known as exhausted emotions. You give up, you panic, and one foot of water, you start believing that this is not going to work. Why? Because it doesn't feel right to you. Because you are allowing your emotions to manipulate your thinking. So you give up. And one foot of water, you start panicking. And one foot of water, your emotions and your senses are lying to you. But you're trusting in your emotions. Your emotions, your senses, they're lying to you. They're sending you false signals. You're thinking that you will fail. But if you just keep trying, if you just keep pushing forward, if you just don't give up, if you don't be manipulated by your emotions, by your exhausted emotions and your deceptive intelligence, then you will make it. See, when your emotions are exhausted, brothers, sisters, and particularly the sisters, because you're more emotional than men, but many of the men are very emotional because you're being raised by single women. So when your emotions are exhausted, they will send you false thoughts. They will send you false signals. They will make you feel as if you are in danger when you're really not in danger. When your emotions are exhausted, they will make you think that the ones that love you hate you. When your emotions are exhausted, you can't trust no one. They make you think you can't trust the people that you can trust. They make you think you cannot trust your loved one that you can trust. They make you think that your loved one may be cheating on you because your emotions are exhausted. When your emotions are exhausted, they make you yell and lash out and say awful things to the one that is actually trying to really help you because your emotions are exhausted. You see, you can't trust your emotions, brothers, sisters, because you are tired and you're exhausted and your emotions are not clear. A psychiatrist told me that when one has exhausted emotions, they will feel like they're driving towards a brick wall at 160 miles an hour with no brakes. But they're really safe. But their emotions are exhausted, so they're not thinking clearly. They're thinking with their emotions because they're tired. Your emotions are exhausted, so your perception of reality is altered. You cannot trust these emotions. Exhausted emotions will make you feel paranoid and fearful when everything's fine, because it's your thinking. Exhausted emotions deprive you of the pleasure of surviving the storm. You may have gotten what you wanted to get, but when you get there, you didn't know it was actually going to be such a test to get there. Nothing great comes easy, but since it was such a test, when you get the operation so you can have that baby, when you get that home that you wanted, when you get that car that you wanted, you're ready to give up everything. Now you have your wife, you have your home, you have your car, you wanted the things that you wanted to get, but you didn't know it was going to be such a test. So you say it don't feel right because you're emotional. So you give up. You didn't know it was going to be such a test, but you're trusting your emotions. You can't trust your feelings, brother. You can't trust your feelings, sister. The scriptures say it like this in Proverbs 3 verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and soul. Don't trust in your emotions. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and soul and lean not towards thy own understanding. Why? Because your understanding may come from exhausted emotions. Your judgment is off and you can't think logically. So you may give up because you allowed your emotions, your exhausted emotions, to control you instead of you controlling your exhausted emotions. They're sending you false perceptions of reality. Brothers, you are supposed to be in the image and likeness of the Creator. We're supposed to be kings. So do not break down. Do not give up. Stand strong. It's your responsibility to lead these sisters correctly. Don't make decisions off of exhausted emotions. Exhausted emotions.
Alright, shalom, shalom. Once again, you're now Kahan Tiger Doc, and I'm here with the Princes Heaven. The last time, you know, I was actually trying to get her to, you know, to make a video. It was distorted for whatever reason, or maybe the tube was actually playing around with the volume, so I got it back here because a lot of people was actually saying that they really couldn't hear what she was saying. So, you know, this is kind of a spontaneous thing, and there's a lot of things going on in the world right now. A lot of relationships breaking up, a lot of drama with families, a lot of separations, because we're actually, believe it or not, we're actually living in those last days that was actually prophesied by Hamas Yahya Hawashah in Matthew the 24th chapter. So unless you get your minds right, king, princes, unless you get your minds right, then you're not going to be part of this setup. You're not going to make it into the kingdom. But I want to say this to people that's like quick to judge. You know, you see someone do something, and you're quick to judge without, like, you know, really getting a full picture. Or even if someone actually did commit a wrong against you, you want to have mercy. The book of Proverbs 3 verse 3 says, let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them around your neck. So when someone does something unjustly against you, you gotta have mercy. You gotta be merciful like Hamas Yahya Hawashah was. If Hamas Yahya was not merciful and forgiving, then we wouldn't be here at this moment, because the Yasha Allah would have actually been destroyed. So you gotta learn to be more merciful with your spouse, with your, you know, with your loved ones, with friends, or even so-called friends. You gotta let that go, you gotta forgive him so that you could actually be able to move on. And you actually also have to deal with truth. It says, let's not mercy and truth forsake you. So you gotta deal with the truth. Now you could, you know, you could conjure a lot of lies up in your mind to make yourself feel better about something you may have done unjustly. But if you're not coming from the right spirit, it's not gonna be prosperous. So you're not gonna be, operating in truth, in the spirit of truth, which is the spirit of Hamas Yahya Hawashah, So you know, let this mind be in you, the same that was in Christ Jesus, meaning the Hamashiach. So with that, having, you know, considering, you know, the current situations, you know, you see a lot of our people are just like spazzing out because Donald Trump just became the president of the United States of America, USA, under Satan's authority. If America's already under Satan's authority, why should our people be concerned about Donald Trump being president if they believe in the Most High? What's your take on that?
Well, I should say this. I wonder who is he being controlled by? You know? That is something to concern yourself with. Because we tend to pick out, we say, we want him to be president. However, do you know anything about this man? Do you know who you're picking? Do you know him, not just in a physical aspect of just being around him or hearing about him on the news? Do you know him down to a T about who he is before you just say, that's who I want as president? Because do you feel his energy? Do you feel anything about him? Do you know who he worship? Do you know who he praise? Do you know what he do and who he condone and what he do not condone? Because if you don't know anything about the revolution and evolution that revolves within Donald Trump, then, you know, I feel like you need to be careful about him.
Well, I mean, he's already been selected, not elected, because if you know anything about corporations, and America is a corporation, according to 28 UFC 3002 subsection 15A, corporations select presidents, not elect. So votes actually meant nothing. It was already predestined that Donald Trump was actually going to sit on the seat of Satan. But now you have a lot of so-called black people emotionally upset. As you see, they've been like protesting in the streets when they should be concentrating on, you know, the love of Hamashiach. If you truly believe in the Most High, why are you concerned about, you know, who's president? In the book of John 14, verse 6, it says, and Yahawashah said to him, I am the way. So Donald Trump is not the way, the truth. So Hamashiach is the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. So Donald Trump's not going to get you in the kingdom. Only keeping these laws, statutes, and commandments and following Hamashiach will get you in the kingdom. So, you know, I seen there was like a lot of protests in various cities throughout America because Trump was elected, and a lot of, you know, so-called blacks, they're discontent with that. You know, they're disgruntled. Like, how do you feel about that? Do you think they should have been protesting? Not that it's going to make any difference, because the man has already been, you know, placed in office, and he's going to be inaugurated in the office in January.
To be honest with you, you know, I feel like a lot of people should have done a lot more. However, I won't speak on that because I'm not out there protesting. I'm not out there trying to say that's who I want either, because I don't stand my ground on that either. I don't, like you said, why go for it if you're not really, if you in the Most High, why really go for that? Why even, you know, put yourself, why even walk yourself around? My beliefs are a bit more different, but I do believe in the truth and light as you spoke about, and then also in the physical. Now, you also giving yourself to the devil, as you say.
Right. Now, you know, so what do you think? You know, there's a lot of people that's actually, just about everybody that I encounter, it's like going through something. You know, there's a brother a couple days ago, he told me that his brother found, you know, his wife committing adultery. You know, she had just finished having sex with him, and he goes out to a Red Lobster and see her with another man. And she tells him straight to his face, now you know I don't want to be with you. And she just had a baby by this man. So, you know, with all of the wickedness and stuff going on like that, you know, I just want to say this. You know, Proverbs 4 verse 23 says, keep your heart in all diligence. So you have to be diligent to this truth, for out of it springs the issues of life. Put away you a deceitful mouth. So if you're lying, a deceitful mouth is what that lady did. She's telling this man that she loved him, but she's running off. And then, you know, she's actually committing adultery with another man. And so, what do you think of something like that? You know, she's telling this man she really care about him and so on and so forth. She just had a baby bond. And now he literally catches her out on a double date with another man. And she tells him to his face, now, you know, I don't want to be with you. could be faking a situation like
that. I believe that.
That,
you know, if you're going to handle yourself in that way, I believe that you should really take care of that through and through, you know, in a personal way. You should make sure your spouse knows your feelings and about what you don't want, if you don't want to be with them, so that way you don't have to put yourself in that type of situation. Now, whether it's wrong or right, I feel like he shouldn't have to go out here catching his wife or seeing his wife with another man. You know, that is, I'm sure that's very hurtful to, you know, her husband or whatever. But with that being said, I feel like she should have said, I don't want you no more. I don't want to be married to you anymore. I think everything should have been handled. And a lot of that has to do with a lot of people is not really married to who they're ordained to be. You know, the Most High have an individual set up for us to be with. Therefore, we end up saying yes to the wrong individual. We end up falling in lust and being with people who we were never to be with. But it's nothing more but setup. So we don't see ourselves and we don't see what it is that we're doing. We don't see what's in front of us. And when we hear him tell us no, we are to say no. When we hear him say, tell us to say yes, we are to say yes. But when we don't follow his word in every footstep and everything, then you find yourself in a position and in a situation you ought not to be in. Even though it might not have been the correct situation, it might not have been right, but that's the situation that you end up being in because you're saying yes to the wrong forces, to the wrong people anyway. So you done married a man that you probably wasn't supposed to be with no way. However, you're married now. So therefore, if you're gonna handle yourself in that way, you need to make sure your husband know everything about your feelings, your emotions. You need to let him know everything that you're gonna do. And y'all need to have some agreement on it. So that way, he's not gonna act crazy. You're not gonna act crazy. You guys need to have an understanding. And that's just how I feel about it. I care not to speak on another person's marriage because I see the world a little bit differently. But I don't believe that husband and wife should cheat on each other. That's why I believe that we should be with true lovers.
Come. Well, you know, it's not really what you and I believe. It's what the Heavenly Father said. So, you pointed out something, so you said you should check them out in the beginning. The scriptures say this. 1 John 4, verse 1. It says, beloved, believe not every spirit. So just because someone say that they love you, don't necessarily mean that they love you. So, what they say with their lips, they have to support with their actions. If they don't, then it's not just balance in the alliance. So the scriptures say to try every spirit. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit, whether they be of Yahweh, the one that you call God, because many false prophets are going out into the world. So it turns out that, you know, this sister wasn't of the Most High, and she was using perverse lips to deceive this man, and on the flip side, she was running out, committing adultery, you know, making herself a scorn. So again, I'm going to read Proverbs 4 and 23. It says, keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. Put away from you a deceitful mouth, meaning a lion, like she deceived the man. Let your eyes look straight ahead. You know, if you're married, your focus is supposed to be on your husband, or your focus is supposed to be on your wife and your family. That's your number one, actually your second priority. Your first priority should be to the Most High, because that will keep you on the straight and narrow path. And your eyelids look right before you. Ponder the path of your feet. So you gotta question the way that you're gonna walk. You can't really be listening to your aunt overhead. If your aunt's giving you bad advice, her marriage is messed up, she's gonna give you advice to ruin your marriage. Why? Because the spirit of Satan is coming through her. If your mom is giving you bad advice, you run into your mom, can't rock with that, because you're gonna end up in the same predicament as your mom, old and lonely. If your dad is giving you bad advice, you're gonna end up just like him, like an old man in a wheelchair on a crane or something, because you're not walking in the spirit of the Most High. So, you know, with that, I mean, what word do you have for a sister or a brother that may be actually seeking a spouse or something like that? What's a word that you would actually give them before they just jump into something in the spirit of lust? Because you mentioned lust.
Well, I once was a child. I put away my childish ways, and now I am a woman. I am a woman who desire to and also try to move forward in the footsteps of the Most High Heavenly Father. The footsteps that I am to walk in, and I try and carry in and retain all of my knowledge that I am to retain. And as I retain all of this knowledge, and I'm doing my reading, I'm doing my studies, I'm doing everything that I am to do, and I'm doing my best to stay pure. I'm doing my best to humble myself. I'm doing my best to say, Most High Heavenly Father, please provide me that husband, that love, that true ordained husband that you're going to provide me, so that way I can do the right thing in every which way, in every which aspect. That is what I shall share with you sisters out here, is that if you want true love, if you want a husband, and you want the marriage to go correctly, I suggest you bow down. You bow down from the heaven to the heavens up above. You bow down to heaven. When you bow down to heaven, you bow down to heaven, and you become heavenly. And when you become heavenly, you shall receive all that you ought to receive. And that is all I have to say.
Yeah, the book of James 1:19, you talking about slow to anger. But everything that we're talking about is in scripture. Like, I like to support everything with scripture. James 1:19 says, know this, beloved brothers, but let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, and slow to anger. So, you know, just because you hear something, you don't really want to spread rumors, being a talebearer, or spreading a heresy. Because if you're spreading something that's false, the Most High is going to bring judgment on you. But at the same time, we got to actually learn to be slow to anger in our interpersonal relationships, marriage, friendships, families, and so on and so forth. And we got to keep all other forces outside of our marital affairs except for the Most High. Then if someone's really going off, we bring them before the priesthood. Proverbs 16:32 says, he is slow to anger is better than the mighty, and he who rules his spirit than he who takes a city. So it's imperative that you have control of your spirit. But that goes back to what I've been talking about in my last couple of videos, about putting on a new mind, about being born again, about having the mind of a Mashiach the Hawashah. So all of your problems essentially exist within your mind. Once you clear your mind and change your thinking, then your whole perception of this reality that you've actually created will change. You gotta work with that. I mean, what do you think people could do to actually change the situation that they're in if their situation is not so good?
Well, I suggest that, just relax yourself. Once you relax yourself, you channel in nothing more but good energy. Once you channel in nothing more but that good energy that you ought to channel in, that belongs to you, you shall see things in the way that you ought to see things. When you see things correctly, you begin to slow down your anger and your wrath that you have towards your enemy, towards your opponent. Because then you'll become a little bit more better with yourself. When you slow down that hatred that you have within, you begin to do things in a better way. You handle things a little bit more better. And then you won't be so hateful towards one another.
Right.
You'll be able to create peace with one another. And that is just what I have to say. Take yourself through a few steps and processes that will actually make you feel better within inside of you, within your body. If you control the spirit, you control the body. If you control the body, you control the spirit. If you control the mind, you control everything within you. So therefore, once you learn to master thy own self, then you can master someone else.
So you believe that once someone masters their mind, then they're on the right path?
Someone mastered their own mind, yes, they are on the right. Like I said, master thine own self, and then you could try and master someone else. You can't be so out here so quick to hate another sister or brother, or to hate the truth, and you ain't mastered yourself yet. You can't force no one to love you. You can't force no one to come in with side of your energy, with inside of your energy field. If you can't master yourself.
So, what do you think that actually gives people hope? And let me get a scripture on that. In the book of Romans 5:5 says, now hope, and in order to have hope, you have to have faith. I'm going to hit you with something. I say this, many of you heard me say this over and again. If you think negative, if you think negative thoughts, the only thing you could possibly get from those negative thoughts is negative results. You have to erase all of the negation, the self-negation, the self-loathing, and fulfill it with positive thoughts. If you think that your marriage is going to go bad, guess what? It's going to go bad because it's coming from your thoughts, and you're going to play your part and act that out. If you think you're not going to be successful in life, not going to create your own business that you want to do, not going to have the job that you want, then guess what? It's not going to happen because it's actually coming from your thinking. And as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Now we know that the Bible is written in a masculine form, so that applies to sisters also. The scriptures say this, Romans 5 verse 5. Now hope does not disappoint as long as you have faith, because the love of Yahweh has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. The Holy Spirit is the Mashiach Yahweh Shah. But in order to walk in the Spirit, you have to birth a new thought. You need a regeneration, which means to be born again into a new mind. You cannot continue doing the same old things and expect to get different results. So, you know, unless you change your thinking, your reality is not going to change. You could try and blame me, you could try and blame others, but your problem is within you. And I do not have time for someone that's going to stagnate me. You over here, like you all over the place. You're discombobulated, and I try and give you right knowledge. So people like that, I got to cut off from outside of my circumference. Like, my objective is to walk this walk in the truth through the Spirit of Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah. But again, it goes back to Proverbs 3 and 3, I have mercy. I show mercy to those that actually want it and deserve it. So in conclusion, you got anything you actually want to close? I know that you don't have your cover in the room, but you got anything you would like to close with, a word for your sisters out there that might be able to help them? By any good word that you could give them.
No. I shall say this. You know? Be at peace with your wrath. Be at peace with your hatred. Be at peace with your anger. Be at peace with coming between things you ought not to come in between. Be at peace with coming between evolution and revolution. Because a revolution is an evolution. However, when those revolutions and evolutions are formed together, they create different universes. So when they create those different universes within the bodies, within the temples, because you receive the Spirit of the Most High Heavenly Father, because He give you the power when you have the Spirit. I shall say this, when you come in between, you also hurt thine own self. So be at peace with your hatred out there. Be at peace with hurting another. Be at peace with hurting yourself. Be at peace with hurting everything. Be at peace with hurting love. And be at peace with hurting each other. And that is all I have to say as a sobriety.
All right, yeah, so I thank you for actually talking to the people, like, once again. So listen to this video, share this video, like it, and let this reflect upon your spirit. And Most High willing, this will give you a new heart, which is essentially a new mind. Because your real heart is your mind, which is the core of your thinking.
Once again, and now under the sounds of your brother Tyler Dock. Yeah, I really wanted to try to reach you tonight. Our people are in dire need of the truth and hearing the word. Our men, our women, and the children. Because if you have a woman that's halfway in the truth, and you have a man that's halfway in the truth, why are you so astonished that you're rearing children that's only halfway in the truth? So prayer, praise, and proper preaching by the shepherds of Yahweh is what's needed. What you need is the mind of Yahweh Shah. Philippians 2 verse 5 says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Which mind did he have? He had the mind of God.
He said, I and my father are one. Not meaning that they're the same entity, but they were so in tune that he had the mind of Yahweh. He had the mind of Yahweh. This goes to say that he thought like Yahweh thought. That his actions was the actions of the Most High. So he became as the Most High. And we are supposed to be Christ-like. But that is not what I'm seeing from our leaders or the bulk of the people. See, once you are walking in the mind of Yahawashah, let this mind be in you, which was also in Yahawashah. You become like a Job. See, Job was a representation of Yahawashah given to you in the Old Testament. Why do I say this? Because the scriptures say that Job was a perfect and upright man. And we must all strive to be like Job. Be like Yahawashah. He was a perfect and upright man. So don't say that you can't be perfect. When Mashiach tells us to be perfect, this means that you must try harder with what you're doing. You're not trying hard enough. You're saying, oh, I can't get my, happy ever after, because you're not trying. You're blocking your success, brother. You're blocking your success, sister. You took a covenant, for better for worse, but you didn't mean it. See, once you're walking in the mind of Yahawashah, you become as him. You become Christ-like. Book of Job, chapter 1, says this. There was a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job. That man was perfect and upright, and one that feared Yahweh and eschewed evil. So he stayed away from evil. So if evil is within your midst, if your family is evil, if your friends are evil, and you cling to them, and you affiliate with them, is it not fair to say that you are indeed evil? Because you cannot hang around that which is evil and not have evil in you. Righteousness cannot dwell with unrighteousness. Two things cannot occupy the same space at one time. So never say that, oh, no one's perfect. See, that's your excuse to sin. You saying no one's perfect, I can't be perfect, no one's perfect. The scripture said Job was a perfect and upright man. So if you tell in your, if you say in your mind, oh, I can't be perfect, I can't have the perfect this, I can't have the perfect that, guess what? You won't have it. Because you've already fixated in your mind that you're gonna fail, that you're gonna sin, that you're gonna do wrong, that you're gonna commit adultery, that you're gonna let others influence your life from a negative perspective. The book of Matthew, Hamashiach, Yahawashah said this in Matthew 5 and 48. Be ye therefore perfect. Why is he telling you to be perfect if it's not possible for you to be perfect? See, you're blocking it with your thinking. Proverbs 23 and 7. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. You keep blocking your salvation with your thinking. And I'm going to tell you, you may not have a lot of time left. Just about everything that needed to happen before Yahawashah makes his second return has already happened. So it's imminent that he's going to return. It's just a matter of when. And what will you be doing? If he was to return tonight or tomorrow, or you're doing everything that you should be doing? Are you living right? Do you have peace with your spouse? Or are you running out? Are you going over here and doing this and doing that? And you want to blame them? But you better check yourself because it's your thinking. Matthew 5:48 says, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect. See, you become perfect by keeping the Lord's statutes and commandments of Yahweh. So, watch this. When the sons of Yahweh went to praise the Most High, the sons of Job, Satan also went with them. Satan don't have to go for the people that's in the nightclubs, that's out there blowing blunts and so on and so forth, that's out there getting drunk, that's out there committing adultery. He don't have to go after the woman that's always running away from her home and so on and so forth, and the man that's always out going out on his wife, because Satan already had them. And they may not be strong enough to admit it, but Satan has you, and you're not going to make it in the kingdom unless you repent. He has those kind of people. But Satan wants to go for the people, the brothers and sisters, that's trying to live right, that's trying to walk, stay faithful, and just walk, that's trying to stay faithful even when your spouse is blaming you and accusing you for things that you're not doing. You're still remaining a perfect and upright man. You let them go over there and do that, and you still stay strong in this walk. One monkey doesn't stop no shuck. Brother, just because your wife run out on you, don't you become weak and sick, because that will cause you to be condemned. Sister, if your husband is out there playing a whoremonger, do not allow that to entice you to sin. You need to hear me. You got to be strong. This is where the mercy of Proverbs and truth comes in. Proverbs 3:3. Mercy and truth, wear them around your neck. Write them in your heart. So when the sons of God went to praise Yahweh, Satan went with them. Satan was among them. Now, they didn't know that Satan was amongst them. Watch this. Book of Joel 1:6. Now, there was a day when the sons of Yahweh came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came amongst them. Among them. So Satan was with them. So I'm pretty sure the sons of Yahweh was like, what? Satan has been with us also? Satan's amongst us? Watch verse 7. And the Lord said unto Satan, whence comest thou? Where are you coming from, Satan? What are you doing here? And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it. So Satan is not seeking those that's already sinning. He's seeking those of you that's trying to stay right in this walk, that's trying to live right, that's not committing adultery, that's not leaving home when you get into disagreements with your spouse, that's staying faithful, that's obeying the Lord's statutes and commandments, and you must not allow Satan to break you. You must not allow your family or anyone to entice you to do what's wrong, because Satan is coming through the spirit of a family member. Satan is coming through the spirit of a so-called friend. Do not allow Satan to get you. Because we're living in those perilous times that was talked about in 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. These are the perilous times. You see homosexuality, you see marriage, divorces at an all-time record high, and you just becoming another statistic. 2 Timothy chapter 3. This know also that in the last days, so we are in the last days, because we see all of these things occurring right now, brothers and sisters. This know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of themselves. A lot of powerful men. But denying the power thereof, from such turn away. These powerful men, people are only concerned about themselves. You rarely see a good Samaritan anymore. You walk right by people that's actually homeless, and their homelessness may be actually sincere, but you walk right by them as if they don't exist. Yet you consider yourself a righteous man. You walk right by someone sinning and you won't rebuke them or try to correct them through the spirit of Yahweh Baha Shem, Yahweh Shah. You walk right by them. So how do you consider yourselves righteous if you're not doing what is right and you're not trying to prevent them from their sins? Because if you was right, you would get them to do right. That's the mind of Hamashiach. That's the mind of Yahweh. For men will be lovers of themselves, covetous, envious, because of something that another brother may have. You might want the brother's wife. You think his wife is beautiful, the spirit of lust strong on you. You want the man's wife. Proud, powerful. Oh, look at me. Look at, I'm in IUIC. We got the most members. It's the wrong spirit, brother. That's the wrong spirit. Oh, if you ain't here, you ain't in the truth. That's the wrong spirit. That is not the spirit of Hamashiach. I know many of you won't like this, but I got to tell the truth. I got to tell the truth. I will not conform to the ways of man and let you go out there and continuously misguide the people. It's not about numbers. Yeah, you got more members, but are they living according to the Lord's statutes and commandments? Are they doing right? Are they doing what they're supposed to be doing? It's not about the numbers. Boasters, proud, blasphemers. They blaspheme the name of the Most High. Disobedient to parents. Many of your children disrespect you to their face, and you still trying to love them. You know you have a wicked seed. You have wicked children that disrespect you to your face, make you cry, and you still want to love them because they came from your womb. No, the right spirit would get on you, you would cast them out. That's a bad seed. You give them a chance to repent. They don't want to repent. You're going to have to decide what you love more, the Most High or your wicked children. I'm going to tell you straight. I got to tell you straight because I love you. Unthankful, unholy, you know, you're wicked, without natural affection. This is talking about the homosexuality, the lesbians, you know? And then you got preachers that's actually supposed to be the shepherds of the Most High. They claim to be the shepherds of the Most High, but you will marry lesbians in your church and you will marry homosexuals in your church because you're more concerned about your 501c3 or C4 grant and what America thinks of you. You've conformed to the ways of this world and you're not of the Most High. You're misleading the flock of the Most High. And you're supposed to be the shepherds. And guess what? When Hamashiach returns, and I think it's going to be very soon, the first place that he's going to bring judgment is in the house, in the houses of the Most High, in all these churches that's supposed to be set up to be the house of the Most High. That's the first place that he's going to bring judgment, just like Moses when he came down with the Ten Commandments. He said, Aaron, what was you doing? See, Aaron was a shepherd. Moses left Aaron in charge of the flock. He said, why are these people worshiping a golden calf? I left you in charge. So he brought judgment on Aaron. And that's what Yahushua is going to do to you wicked leaders. You're marrying homosexuals. You're marrying lesbians. Preacher, why are you leading a congregation if you're trying to run up in every woman up in the church? That's not of the Most High. That's not of Yahushua. Having, without natural affection, the homosexuals, the lesbian, truth breakers, you break contract. What does that mean? You take an oath for better or for worse, and you break it. Things get a little tough. You're ready to dissolve your marriage. Brothers, sisters, have you not learned that you may as well take what you have and work with it? You got to try. You got to push through the difficult times because you love this person at one time. And if you get your mind right, that love will be turned. Or if you turn your life over to Yahusha, that love will return. But you got to live by these Lord's statutes and commandments. You're conforming to the ways of the world. You want to listen to your mother. You want to listen to your aunt. You want to listen to everybody else except what this Bible says. Sisters, you're not supposed to go and take another husband. You in this truth? You can't just leave your husband and go and let another man run out in you, run up in you. You think you're going to enter the kingdom like that? You're not going to make it. You're not going to make it. Get your minds right. Brothers, you can't be playing a whoremonger. You're not going to make it in the kingdom. Teaching Yahweh is not no big business that you're supposed to be making money off of. You got to teach the truth. You got to teach these laws. Our people are going to be destroyed because they will not keep these laws. Just about everything that needs to happen has already happened before Yahawashah's second return. So his return is imminent, and it could be tomorrow. But my question is, if he returns tomorrow, are you ready? Will you be in his favor? That's the question. Will you be in his favor? Will he find you in his favor? That's the question. And if not, you're condemned. You're condemned. Truth breakers, false accusers, lying, impotent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. You hate people that do good. Many of you don't like me because I try to live right. Many spouses turn against each other because one try to live right, and you can't stand to be in the presence of someone that lives right, so you try to find little things. Relationship could be just fine. You go looking for things. Don't you know that's the spirit of Satan? You going through your husband's phone looking for stuff. You looking for problems. It's all in your mind. Once you get a regeneration of your mind, then you'll be all right. But you need to be born again into a different spirit. Why are you looking for problems? That is the spirit of Satan. And unless you repent and clean yourselves up, you're not going to make it. You're not going to make it into the kingdom. Having a form of godliness, but denying the powers thereof, from such turn away. So we're supposed to turn away from these sort of people. For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women. Some Israelites come talking real smooth, or sister, I'm in the truth. Yeah, your husband was no good. I'll treat you a lot better, and so on and so forth. And some of you women are so damn gullible. And he doesn't necessarily have to be an Israelite. Just a smooth talking man come along and he talk you out of your panties, and you're committing adultery. And your ass is condemned. Excuse my language, but I gotta tell you straight. Don't fall for it. Don't fall for it, sisters, brothers. Don't fall for it. That lustful woman out there is trying to entice you to sin. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. So they don't want the truth. So brothers and sisters, we are in such times. Our people are in dire need of proper prayer. Our people are in dire need of proper teaching and preaching and praise and fasting. And our people will only be made fit for the kingdom of Yahweh if they get the proper preaching and proper teaching that will restore a proper family life and revive their spirits and put them in the proper spirit. Because this world has gone materially crazy. You're going materially crazy. You want the material things. Oh, I want me a nice Benz and so on and so forth. I want a big house in the hills and so on and so forth. But what about your soul? What about your spirit? I'm not saying that you can't have these things, but seek ye first the kingdom of the Most High. Then all these things will be given unto you. See, HaMashiach warned you not to be heedless of the signs of the time. And as I stated, everything that needs to happen has pretty much already happened before he returned. So his return is imminent. This is why he's saying,
watch and pray. You better be watching and praying that you're doing the right thing, that you're not doing the wrong thing when he returns. Because if you are, he's not coming back with no olive branch. That's not he's coming for the second return. He's coming with a vesture dipped in blood. He's coming for judgment. So again, sister, how you living? Will he find you in his favor? Are you making righteous judgments? Are you making righteous decisions? Brother, will he find you in his favor? That's the question. That's the industry rhetorical. You don't have to answer it. The question is, will you be ready? And will he find you in his favor? The scriptures do not say that Hamashiach will return with an olive branch. It does not say that he will come back preaching and praying. It says he will return for judgment. For judgment. Matthew chapter 10 verse 34 says it like this. Think not that I come to send peace on earth. I have not come to send peace, but a sword. It's talking about judgment. This is talking about warfare. This is talking about putting you to death if you're not living how you should be living. Verse 35, for I come to set a man at variance against his father. So if you are in the truth and your family's not in the truth, guess what? Hamashiach's going to separate you. And the daughter against her mother. So if your mother don't want to hear this and you're in the truth, Most High is going to separate you from it. And I know this sounds harsh, but I'm reading from the scriptures. I'm not making this up. And the daughter-in-law against the mother-in-law. And a man's foes shall be those of his own household. Is this not being fulfilled as we speak? Sometimes your greatest enemy is your spouse. It's your wife. She plot and scheme against you. She still love you. But she think of all these wicked things about you. Same thing. The husband plot and scheme against the wife. A man's foes will be those of his own household. And someone that has lived with you and studied you, they know your weaknesses and they know how to hurt you in the worst place. So they will try and desecrate your name, make you feel bad, and get you to do wrong. So you can sin, but don't do it. You gotta be like a Job. Don't be like Job's wife, because she told him to curse Yahweh and die. You gotta be a Job. Understand that. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. This is what Yahushua said. If you love your mother more than the Yahushua, you're not worthy of him. He that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. You know your children are wicked. Your children are adults now. You've been trying to teach them, they don't want to hear it. If you side with your children over your Yahushua, guess what? You're not going to make it in the kingdom. And many of you under the sounds of my voice right now are guilty of this and won't change it because of your love for your children. And not your Yahushua. You're not going to make it. And you're going to get caught up. You're going to get caught up and not make it. Man, I hope this message is touching you because this is real. This is not a joke. This is not a game. This is serious. Now the new thing is this knowledge fact. Oh, everybody want to be so knowledgeable. Oh, I speak Hebrew. Oh, your teacher don't speak Hebrew. Are you keeping these laws, statutes, and commandments? Are you keeping the laws? Are you living right? Are you doing what these scriptures say? Verse 38, and he that taketh not his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. So if you end this war, you're going to have to go through some hardship. Your wife may come against you. You can't break. So what your wife telling you? So I want a divorce. Divorce her then. Stay strong in this truth. Do not fall out of this truth. If you've tried everything that you can try, you tried your hardest, and she wants to go, let her go. Brother, the Most High will bless you with someone better and nearer in faith. You just gotta have faith. One monkey doesn't stop no show. You cannot let anyone deter you from this war. Do not fall out of this truth, brother. Do not fall out of this truth, sister. Your husband wanna play a whoremonger? Shalom, have a nice day. You can't, don't you go out there and take another man and sin. Don't let him entice you to sin. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it. You worried about, Donald Trump's the next president. Oh, so much racism. Forget about that. Who do I care about who the president is? My king is Yahweh Shah. What do I care about who they put in office? Doesn't make any difference who they put in office. My king is Yahweh Shah. So brothers and sisters, he's not returning with an olive branch. He's not returning that way this time. His second return is for judgment. The judgment. Book of Revelation 12 verse 12 says that like this. Therefore rejoice ye heavens and ye that dwell in them. Woe, the word woe means destruction, to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath a short time. So Satan is turning it up. This is why you're seeing so many divorces. This is why you're seeing like people so damn discombobulated. Like families just falling apart. Because Satan is turning up his wrath. So the spirit of Satan, you know, you want to live right. You want to be honest. You're trying to do the best that you can with your family. And for no reason, your spouse wants to go out and commit adultery. Or he wants to run around. Or she wants to run around. That's Satan. That's Satan on there. They're doing things and they don't even understand why they're doing it. Because they don't believe that this is a spiritual warfare. That is Satan on there. That's Satan, brother. So they need to fast and pray. Brothers, get your mind right. Satan knows that he has a short time. So he's going to turn up the wrath. Revelations 12 and 12. For the devil is come down unto you. So he's here. Having great wrath. It's going to cause hardship in homes. More and more divorces are going to take place. Because he knoweth that he had a short time. Revelations 19 and 15. But watch this. Watch this. Look how Mashiach is coming back. Revelations 19, 15. And out of his mouth goeth a short sword. That's the judgment. He's going to judge you for your actions that you think he does not see. So you better repent quickly and return to these Lord's statutes and commands. I know many of you think you have a lot of time, but I really don't think you have a lot of time. And out of his mouth goeth a short sword, that with it he shall smite, the word smite means destroy, the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and tread up the winepress. Now, I don't know if any of you know what an old winepress was. When people were actually getting a winepress, they would get on the grapes and smush it with their feet until the garment was like a bloody red from the grapes, from smushing the grapes. This is how Hamashiach's vesture is. But it's dipped in blood. It's not grapes. Why? Because he's returning for the judgment. He's nothing like this Christ that they talk about in your churches. And if you doubt it, read it for yourself. Revelations 19 verse 15. And out of his mouth goeth a short sword, that with it he shall smite the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and tread up the winepress of fierceness and the wrath of Almighty Yahweh. So he's returning for judgment on his second coming. Again, are you in his favor? Are you living right, sister? Sisters, are you obeying your husband if your husband is a righteous man? Fact of the matter is, most sisters have no clue how to go out and look for a righteous, Yah-fearing man. you're selecting based on your emotions. You're selecting based on how financially stable he is or how attractive he may be. But you're not looking for a righteous fear of man, so you get a man that drinks all of the time, smoke weed all of the time, committing adultery, and so on and so forth. Then he damaged you mentally, and so the next brother that you take has it really hard, even though you're not supposed to take anyone else. Once you come into this truth and you know this, you're not supposed to go out and lay with any other man. But how many of you gonna do this? How many of you gonna keep these laws and do that? So, remember, when the sons of Yahweh went to worship, they didn't know that Satan was amongst them. They didn't know that Satan, they probably was like, what? Satan was with us? So when the Most High said, whence comest thou, Satan? Satan said, I've been going to and fro in the earth, up and down in it, looking for those that I could find to say. Now my question, does Satan have you? Has Satan been using you to cause problems in your home? Has Satan been using you to cause division in your home? That's the question. That's the question, Book of Joel 1 verse 6. And now, there was a day when the sons of Yahweh came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan was amongst them. See, Satan was amongst them. And the Lord said unto Satan, whence comest thou, Satan? Answered the Lord, and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it. See, Satan is seeking who he can consume. Satan is seeking whom he can devour. I don't mean the wicked, because he already got them in his hip pocket. He's looking for the righteous. Those of you that's trying to live right. That's who he wants. He already has the wicked. He doesn't have to consume them. So, many of you, you think that you're serving Yahweh. You think that you are a body of Yahweh Shah. You think that you are a body of Christ. And you're supposed to be the body of Christ, but what? You're already being consumed by Satan. Many of you preachers, you leaders, you teachers, you think that you are teaching the word of the Most High. But you've made the house of the Most High a house of demons. A house of demons. Your prayers are not right. So, the people that listen to your prayers are not right. Because your prayers are made to heave up to the ears of men and not the Most High. Your preaching is not right. You're not preaching for the right purpose. You're preaching for vain purposes. This is why you're always talking about a revival. You're always talking about restoration because you are not preaching and teaching right. Yahweh Shah is a constant revival. This is why he said in John 14 verse 6, Yahweh Shah saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So, what's going on in these places of worship? What is it that they need revival? What is going on in these places of worship that they need restoration? See, if you was living right, you wouldn't need revival. If you was living right, you wouldn't need restoration because you would actually already be living right. But Hamashiach is coming back to judge. He's coming back for judgment. And I, being a spiritual man, do not want to be in disfavor with him when he returns. Understand that. He may return tomorrow. I don't know. All the signs are already in place. And you can think this is funny all you want to. You can think it's a joke all you want to. But many of you, you conform to the ways of this world. You conform to the ways of this world. You want to please man instead of pleasing Yahweh. See, I cannot conform to what this world wants me to be. I cannot conform to what a woman wants me to be. I cannot conform if she wants to prevent me from serving my God, Yahweh. So many of you, watch this. You claim to love Yahweh Shah. You claim to love Christ, but you will not do the things that he directed, sisters. 1 Corinthians 11 chapter, verse 1 through 4, said that the divine order is Yahweh Shah, the man, and then the woman, meaning you're supposed to obey your husband. How many of you do that? Pride, anger gets in the way. Pride and anger. And that may stop you from making it into the kingdom. See, if you love him, you would actually have a personal relationship with Yahweh Shah, sisters, brothers. And if you love him, you would actually do what he tells you to do. If you love him, he would actually always be in your thoughts. So when you make decisions, you would not make decisions without thinking, would Yahweh Shah agree with what I'm doing right now? Would he agree with the way that I'm thinking right now? If you love him, he will consistently be in your thoughts. If you love him, he will be pleased by the things that you're doing right now. Is he pleased with what you're doing right now? And if he's not pleased with what you're doing, is it fair to say that you're sinning? And is it fair to say that if he was to return tomorrow or tonight, you wouldn't make it into the kingdom? So, two things cannot occupy the same place at one time. And this is why Paul would not leave the people in Galatians until they actually receive Yahweh Shah, until they actually receive Christ. Because Yahweh Shah was not formed in them. Christ was not formed in them. But watch this. If you don't have the power, brother, sister, you leaders, if you do not have the power to condemn sin, then Christ, Yahweh Shah, is not formed in you. If you do not have the power to condemn your own sins, then Yahweh Shah is not formed in you. If you do not have the power to prevent your own evil doings, then Yahweh Shah is not formed in you. If you do not have the power to inspire men and women to do that which is right, Yahweh Shah is not formed in you. Christ is not formed in you. Why? Because if he is in you, then you have power. You have power to be Christ-like. So then you should have the ability to conform, brothers and sisters. But if you don't have that power, he's not in you. Understand that. If you do not have the power to actually inspire brothers and sisters to change their lives, to stop sinning, if you do not have that power, then Yahweh Shah is not formed in you. Yahweh Shah is not formed in you. And Yahweh is not formed in you. Because he was one with the Father. See, I'm not talking about just the name, like you out there debating over his name, or his name's Yeshua, his name's Yahweh Shah, his name's Yeshaya. I'm not talking about debating over the name. I'm talking about Christ, Yahweh Shah, becoming so real that when people see you, they see Christ. They see HaMashiach when they see you. I'm talking about living him. I'm talking about living him, that when people see you, they see an expression of an Hashem. Then there's no need to talk about restoration. There's no need to talk about revival because they are revived in you. See, the black man, so-called black man, is a destroyed man. He's a destroyed man. They're not good fathers. They're not good husbands. You know? Many are hypocritical. He's a destroyed man. They love to talk Yah with their lips. But they're far from him. They're far from him. See, I'm a different kind of Hebrew. I'm a different kind of Israelite. I'm not your typical Hebrew Israelite. I'm a special man. Why am I special? Because I recognize that I was made in the image and likeness of my Father, which is in heaven. This is why. When they asked the Master, how do we pray? He didn't say his Father. He didn't say my Father. He said our Father, which are in heaven. So if he's Yahawashah's Father and he's my Father, then I am the brother of Yahawashah. So if I'm the brother of Yahawashah, the same things that are in Yahawashah is in me. The same things that are in Christ is in you. And leaders, the same things that's in Yahawashah is in those out there that are lost and sinning, but you just need to help them to discover it. So we have a difficult job to do. We have a difficult job to do. So brothers, sisters, Yahawashah is Alpha. Salakia, Yahawah is our Father. And Yahawashah is our brother. He's our elder brother. And that same essence that is in him is in me, it is in you, and it's in her. It is our duty to help them to discover, or at least try to help them to discover. This is why the disciple said in 1 John 4:20, if any man say, I love Yahweh, and hateth his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother whom he seen, how can he love Yahweh whom he had never seen? You see, the same thing that you praise in Yahawashah is buried in each one of us. Even those out there that are lost. Even in those jakes out there that are lost. So we have a lot of work to do. You leaders, you claim, well, I'm saved. I know I'm saved. And many of the leaders say, oh, well, I know I'm saved. Yet you claim to be saved. Yet you'll walk right by your brother who's sinning to get to your destination. Yet you claim that you are saved. How can you tell me about your righteousness and your people are dying and you walk right by them? How can you tell me that you're righteous? You see, some of you are content because you have fellowship with the big Satan. You have a great joy. You're content with it. You fellowship with Satan. But you don't have fellowship with the one that is coming back. See, I do not want to conform to this world. I am not concerned about pleasing this world. I'm concerned about pleasing the one that's returning with judgment. This is why he would say to many of you leaders that's supposed to be leading the flock, many of you shepherds, he's going to say, depart from me, O wicked. Matthew 7:21 says, Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. Many will say to me in the day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? See, you talk Yahweh with your lips. And in thy name have we not cast out devils? And in thy name have we done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew thee. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. See, they talk Yah with their lips. See, he's coming back for judgment, not with an olive branch. He's coming back for judgment. And will you be right? Revelation 19 verse 13 says, and he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name was called the Word of Yahweh. Revelation 19 verse 15 says, and out of his mouth goeth a short sword, that with it he shall smite the nations. This is judgment. This is talking about judgment. See, I don't want to be wrong when he returns. Will you be ready if he returns tomorrow, sister? Will you be ready if he returns tomorrow, brother? Are you at peace with your spouse? Are you at peace with your husband? Are you trying everything that you actually tried? Try harder. Try harder. See, the book says that no homosexuals, no lesbians, no liars, no adulteries are wanted in the kingdom of the Most High. Now, are you guilty of that? If so, you better repent quickly, because his return could be tomorrow. See, T.D. Jakes is not going to teach you this. He's not going to give you scriptures like this. Joel Osteen is not going to give you scriptures like this. And I don't want to be wrong during his second return, but the preachers are evil. The preachers are evil. And why do you say this, Tyler Doc? Because they allow anything to go on in the house of God. You're in church marrying lesbians, marrying homosexuals, when the book says that no effeminates are wanted in the kingdom of Yahweh, in the kingdom of God. 1 Corinthians 6, 9, and 10. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of Yahweh. Be not deceived, neither fornicators. You want to go up and worship strange gods? You want to be an Egyptologist? You want to worship some kind of other god? You want to be a Buddhist? You want to worship crystals? Guess what? You're not going to enter the kingdom. Now, you could think this is funny all you want to, but when this thing comes down, you won't think it's funny. Nor idolatrous. You want to worship other people? You want to worship these celebrities? Ah, look at that. King James. You know, LeBron James and so on and so forth. Stephen Curry and all this nonsense. That's idolatry, brother, sister. You know, effeminate. It's a man that has a woman's spirit on him. You know, abusers of themselves. You want to abuse yourself with drugs and so on and so forth? You want to cut yourself? Most High is not going to let you in. Nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. Nor abusers of themselves or mankind. Nor thieves, nor covetousness, nor drunkards. You want to get drunk all the time? Nor revilers. Nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. So if we want to be a part of the kingdom, we got a lot of cleaning up to do. Brothers, sisters, husbands, wives. See, we are supposed to be shepherds. And if we are shepherds, you're going to be judged for misleading the flock. A shepherd has a heck of a job to do. You're shepherds. You're supposed to be the leaders. And if you're a shepherd, you can lead a sheep just about anywhere. How are you leading? How are you leading? It seems to me like preaching has become big business. You want your 501c3 grant. Well, you're conforming to the ways of the world, because with that, you can't preach Yahweh. Brothers and sisters, Book of Joel 1 verse 6 says, now there was a day when the sons of Yahweh came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came amongst them. Satan is amongst us, causing problems in your home, causing problems in your marriage, and you're not wise enough to see it. To see it. I encourage you to fast and pray. Fast and pray. Stop sinning. Make peace. Make peace with your spouses. You took a covenant for better or for worse. But if they run off and leave you, shalom, have a nice day, let them go. Just stay strong in the faith. Do not allow anyone to deter you from this truth. Do not fall out of this truth. Because you won't make it. You won't make it. You better be a Job. The Most High said, have thou considered my servant Job? Joel 1 verse 10, has thou made a hedge about him? This is Satan said, has thou made a hedge about him and about his house and about all that he had on every side? Thou hast blessed the work of his hand, and his substance is increased in the land. But put forth thy hand now and touch all that he had, and he will curse thee. And the Most High said to Satan, and the Lord said unto Satan, behold, all that he hath is in thy power. Only upon him put forth not thine hand. So Satan went forth from the presence of the Lord. And this is why you gotta be like a Job. You gotta be like Christ. You gotta be Christ-like. See, Job was a representation of Yahweh Shah in the Old Testament. You must never lose your faith. You must be able to rebuke the present wrongs or the wrongs in your present. You must teach the truth. Leaders, you must teach the truth. So in my conclusion, share this message. If you like this video. Someone needs to hear this message. This message needs to touch someone's spirit, and it may inspire them to do the right thing. Once again, I'm going to say Shalom, Yasha'Allah, and Kwam Yasha'Allah. I am Tazadok. Share this video. Shalom, Yasha'Allah. Make peace. Make peace in your home. Do not fall out of this truth. Do not be deterred by anyone. Shalom.